Welcome to Bachelor Course of Physical Education. Today, we will discuss heredity and environment and their relative importance in growth and development of an individual. Our behavior is influenced by two important forces, that is heredity and environment. Heredity is anything we inherit from our parents. Broadly, heredity is of three types: biological, sociocultural, and material. Biological heredity stands for sum total of the traits potentially present in the fertilized ovum. It is the transmission of the traits from one generation to the other through genes. Sociocultural heredity is the transmission of the mores, cultural values, from one generation to another. Material heredity is getting material objects from forefathers in the form of property, bank balance, jewelry, etc. Here we will emphasize biological heredity because sociocultural and material heredity comes under environment. According to Woodworth, heredity covers all the factors that are present in the individual when he began life right from conception, about 9 months before birth. B.M. Jha viewed heredity as the sum total of the inborn individual traits. Biological heredity includes the following three types of traits. Number one, physical traits, that is color of the eyes, hair, type of the skin, shape of the skull, size of the hands, legs, and internal glands, etc. Mental traits like reflex actions, instincts, intelligence, emotional stability, and higher mental processes such as memory, abstract thinking, reasoning, judgment, appreciations, and attention, etc. Other personality traits like we partially inherit aptitudes, sensory equipment, etc. Even the color blindness, baldness, stub fingers, and tendency to certain diseases like cancer, tuberculosis, and mental diseases are inherited to great extent. These innate traits provide the raw material to the personality. Biologically, heredity stands for all those potentials which are present in the child at the time of fertilization. It provides tendencies for the individual to develop in a particular way. As discussed, all the physical traits are transferred biologically from parents to the offspring, but still differences exist among siblings. Children are not replica of their parents. These can be better understood when we go through the laws and mechanism of heredity. Now we will take up laws of heredity. First law is like begets like. This law states that children tend to be similar to their parents. Children of tall parents tend to be tall. Those of the short parents tend to be short. Similarly, bright parents tend to have bright children and dull parents tend to have dull ones. But sometimes we see white parents have black children and bright parents have less bright children. So the first law is not universally true. Now I'll take up the law of variation. This principle states that children are not the exact replica of their parents. According to this law, white parents may have black children and intelligent parents may have dull children. This can be justified when we study the detailed mechanism of heredity. Law of regression. It is the tendency of the children of very bright parents to be less bright than their parents, and tendency of the children of less intelligent parents to be less inferior to their parents. There is the tendency of the offspring to proceed towards the normal side. These laws help us in understanding human qualities and characteristics. Now we will briefly discuss mechanism of heredity. Mating is the first step for reproduction. A human being has its beginning in the union of male germ cell, the sperm, with the female germ cell, the ovum. The union of the male germ cell with the female germ cell causes fertilization of ovum. Fertilized ovum is technically known as zygote. Growth and development takes place by the multiplication of fertilized cell through continuous division. Zygote contains 23 pairs of chromosomes, 23 from the male parent and 23 from the female parent. Out of these, 22 are called autosomes and the 23rd pair is called sex chromosome, which determines the gender of the child. Each autosome is carrier of trait like color of the eye, complexion of the hair, etc. Each chromosome contains about 4200 genes. These genes are carriers of hereditary material. When the two cells unite, one gene remains recessive and the other becomes dominant, and the trait of the parents whose gene is dominant will appear in the offspring and the counterpart will be carried on recessively, that is, it won't show. For example, if the male parent is fair and the female is dark, if the female parent's gene dominates, the offspring will be dark complexion and the gene of the male parent will be carried on recessively. Genetics explain how the sex of a child is determined. Microscopic studies have shown that chromosomes occur in pairs. Thus, the sex cells of male consist of one X and one Y chromosome. The sex cell of the female have two X chromosomes. After the fertilization, there will be either XX combination or XY combination. If there is XX combination, it will be the female child. If there is XY combination, it will be the male child. So, sex of the child is determined at the time of conception. According to chromosome combination, which highlights the fact that chromosome of the male parent determines the gender of the child. Now, I'll take up environment. Environment stands for all those circumstances which are asserting their influence on the child from conception to death. Consciously or unconsciously, environment molds the behavior and personality of the child. Our innate abilities are modified by the circumstances. So an individual's environment is sum total of the stimulation which he receives from the time of his conception until death. Environment consists of physical, intellectual, social, moral, economic, political and cultural forces. All these forces do exert their influence in molding the personality and behavior of the child. Waring and Langfield viewed environment as everything that affects the individual except his genes. In the words of Woodworth, environment covers all the outside factors that have acted on the individual since he began life. To sum up, we can say that the environment is the sum total of the experiences surrounding the individual since conception. Broadly speaking, environment is of three types: physical environment, which includes physical objects surrounding the individual like food, temperature, climate, home and school building. Socio-cultural environment includes parents, members of the family, relatives, playmates, friends, neighbors, teachers and society at large. Mental environment consists of the books around the child, libraries, laboratories, radio, museum, recreational rooms, associations, intellectual tastes and interest of the parents. Now we will take up the relative importance of heredity and environment. A great controversy has appeared in the field of education as regards the influence of heredity and environment in the development of the child. Hereditarians are of the view that heredity is everything in determining the personality of an individual, and education cannot make the child superior if he is inferior. Environmentalists hold the view that environment can give any direction and form to the personality. Controversy between the two groups is endless and very interesting. First, we will discuss the viewpoints highlighting the influence of heredity on development of the individual. Carl Pearson is of the view that the height of the child is influenced by the height of his parents. The child is likely to possess good height if his parents are tall, and is likely to be short statured if his parents are short statured. Influence on the innate powers. Thorndike is of the opinion that innate powers of the child are determined by heredity. Influence on intelligence. According to Goddard, intelligence is inherited. Children of the parents who possess superior intelligence are generally bright, and children of the feeble-minded parents possess low intelligence. Influence on vocational efficiency. Kettle believes that vocational efficiency is significantly influenced by heredity. Influence on social aspect. In the words of Winship, children of noble, eminent and reputed parents attain eminence and reputation. This fact is also verified by Wedgwood, Darwin, Galton family study and study of Carl Pearson's family. Influence on greatness. Galton is of the view that greatness is caused due to heredity. Studies of the life histories of eminent scientists, artists, doctors, politicians, lawyers show that many members of these families attained a reputation and eminence in the same field. Now we will take up the viewpoints highlighting the influence of environment on the development of individual. Influence on physical development. Frank Bowles believes that differences in physique among the different races are caused due to environment and not due to heredity. He has proved that height of the Japanese and Jews who have begun living in America from many generations has increased due to physical environment. Influence on intellectual development. Studies conducted on Ramu, the wolf boy who remained among the wolves and became wolf in eating habits, speech and other traits. Instead of walking, he could only crawl, proved that development suffers in the absence of suitable social and cultural environment. Gordon has also proved that suitable environment is conducive to intellectual development. Influence on identical twins. Physical, intellectual and emotional differences were found when identical twins were brought up in different environment. Newman, Freeman and Holzinger kept 20 identical twins in different environment, kept one member of the each twin in village and the other member of the each twin in the city. Notable differences were found after a few years. Those children who were brought up in the village were more learned, less intelligent, less cultured than those who were brought up in city. Mall take up influence on orphans. Woodworth asserts that orphans who are given suitable environment in the orphanages prove better on the whole than their parents. Influence on different races. Clark is of the view that superior intelligence of the races is the result of environment, not heredity. He proved this fact by giving intelligence test to some white and Negroes of America. Some other psychologists believe that Negroes are less intelligent than whites because they do not get social, cultural, economic and educational environment like the white people. Conclusion regarding relative importance of heredity and environment. By judging the pros and cons of both the systems of thought, it is quite evident that both are equally important. The growth and development of the child is determined by these two factors. It is wrong to assume that these are opposite to each other, but they are complementary. View of Woodworth. To use a simile of stated by Woodworth, the individual is a joint product of heredity and environment, just is the same way as the area of rectangle is the joint product of its length and breadth. It would be absurd to speak of the personality being the product of heredity alone or of the environment alone. It would be odd to talk of the area of a rectangle being due to its length alone or its breadth alone. Heredity is responsible for all the inborn traits, instincts, emotions, intelligence, reflex actions, and physical traits. Environment is responsible for growth and development of physical, intellectual, emotional, and social traits. The view of Landis and Landis. Landis and Landis beautifully remarked, heredity gives us the capacity to be developed, but opportunity for the development of these capacities must come from the environment. Heredity gives us working capital, environment gives us opportunity to invest. View of Sargent. According to Sargent, one cannot exist without other, and we cannot say in running a car whether a motor is more important or gasoline. Both should be there. According to Pinter, raw material is provided by heredity and environment provides opportunities for its maximum development. So child is the product of heredity and environment. In the view of Woodworth and Marquis, according to Woodworth and Marquis, both are equally essential in the growth and development of the child. We cannot say which of the blades of the scissors cuts. Both are important in operation of cutting. In view of Marshall, according to Marshall, as in the free competition, price is the result of both the forces of demand and supply, so is the growth and development of child is the result of both heredity and environment. View of Macker and Page remarked, every phenomenon of life is the product of both. Each is as necessary as the result as the other. To sum up, the following conclusions can be drawn regarding relative importance of heredity and environment. Heredity and environment both play an important role in the development of personality. There can be no simple answer to the question what part heredity plays and what part is played by environment in the developmental process. What we can say is that an individual is the product of heredity and environment. The richer the heredity, the better the scope for personality development. Similarly, the richer the environment, better is the scope for developing an individual to a healthy human being. Heredity does not completely determine any characteristic or trait, but it provides basis or the potential for the development of any personality trait. Training and experience in the environment contribute to the development of the trait. Heredity influences physique, motor sensory equipment, level of intelligence, certain diseases, temperamental and characteristics also inherited from forefathers. Bad environment can suppress good inheritance, but good environment is not a substitute for bad heredity. Heredity sets the limit of the maximum development of characteristics which cannot be crossed by providing best environment. The best environment cannot make a feeble-minded child a bright child. Good training and experience improve the performance. Intelligence is influenced by type of education, occupation of the parents, rural urban living, cultural environment. Substantial differences in intelligence and other aspects of personality can be created by providing suitable environment. The relationship between heredity and environment is not that of addition but of multiplication. The individual is not the sum total of the heredity and environment, but he is the product of heredity and environment. The heredity and environment both are significant factors in the development of personality. None of the two can be ignored. At the same time, neither of the two can be given the prime importance. Both play significant role in growth and development. Thus, heredity and environment are complementary to each other. It becomes clear if we take the analogy of seed and soil. If very productive seed is sown in unfertile soil and not properly taken care of, the potentialities of the seeds will go waste. On the other hand, if we sow a poor quality seed in a very fertile soil and provide quality nurturance, it won't result into very good harvest. So we can say that heredity and environment both play a significant role in the growth and development of the individual. Now we will discuss the educational implications of the knowledge about heredity and environment in the development of individual. The knowledge of laws of heredity. A teacher must know the laws of heredity. He must study the heredity of the child and then mold his educational theory and practice. He cannot guide without proper understanding the inborn traits. He punishes a boy unnecessarily, considering him to be careless when actually he is endowed with weak mental powers. Knowledge of individual differences. While using the various methods of teaching, knowledge of heredity and environment assists the teacher to know the individual differences among students, and hence he should devise means and methods of teaching accordingly. Providing guidance. Educational, vocational and psychological guidance depends upon the knowledge of heredity and environment. In order to provide guidance to the pupils, teachers shall have to know the heredity and environment of the child. Conducive home environment. The home environment should be conducive to proper development of the child. If the home atmosphere is not conducive to development due to bickering and maladjusted parents, there is no scope for improvement in home environment. Child should be sent to hostels or foster homes. Suitable environment in the school. Teacher should provide a suitable environment in the school for all-round development of the child. There must be provision for a variety of co-curricular activities. Library facilities must be adequate. Teaching and Instructional guidance must be efficient. The staff must be qualified and trained, having control over their emotions. The equipment must be adequate. School should be situated in an area, locality with fresh air and sufficient sunlight. It should be properly ventilated and away from distracting sounds. Suitable and social environment. Suitable social environment should be provided because suitable social environment in the neighborhood, in the school, and in the society at large is necessary for harmonious development of personality. Parents, teachers, educationists, and members of the society at large should all try their best to create suitable social environment. To sum up, every individual is the product of hereditary potentialities and environmental opportunities. Hereditary potentialities are whatever an individual receives from the parents or forefathers. Environment is sum total of influences that affects the individual right from conception till death. Heredity and environment both have significant role in developmental process. Parents, teachers, and coaches must understand the importance of heredity and environment in the life of an individual. Before taking up any step of guiding and teaching, they must understand the hereditary potentialities of the individual so that the complementary, supplementary environment can be provided to ensure proper development of the individual. That's all for today's lecture. Thank you.